Hello everyone, it's time to work on my resin geode again, and I'm very pleased with the bubble effect that I get, or that I got in the middle and on the sides. So that's very nice, and I will for sure use this technique in another project. So in this video you will see me add some acrylic lines, because I also want to show you that, and also a clear coat. And I've shown you that in other videos, but yeah, it's part of the process, and that's why I'm also going to show you how I apply a clear coat. And I already started with adding some lines, so I only will add lines to the sides, so not in the middle part, because I want the middle part to stand out a little bit. And also for the new people to my channel, and like tutorials about resin and also experiments in resin and acrylics. I also do alcohol ink and mixed media pieces. Consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So I've also added some blue lines, a thicker blue line and now a thinner one. I'm using different tips. Sizes of Posca markers. All the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites. So if you're curious, then you can check out the description box where I buy my materials. So I'm only adding gold lines and blue lines, and on top of the blue lines I'm going to add a thinner gold line, but that you will see later in this video. Yeah, and the stone coat resin, they do not ship to Europe, but I had something left because I got some comments. And I'm only using the stone coat resin for special projects or for coasters. If I want to have a high heat resistance, then I'm using the stone coat art coat. Here you can see how I add a gold line on top of the blue one. I think that looks nice. And because I only add the lines to the sides, yeah, I think the middle part stands out more, so your eye will get drawn to the middle part and not to the sides. That's how I look at it, but yeah, it's also your personal preference of, yeah, liking the lines or not. I think they look nice. Yeah, some of the lines are not bright enough, and that's why I'm adding a second line on top of it. Yeah, and also at the end of this video, the end results, how it looks then. And this was a very nice experiment to do. And what I already mentioned, I'm going to use it for sure in another project. And I already have something in mind. I think I'm going to use it in a smaller freeform resin geode. I think that would look nice. And also mixing some pigments in the quick coat to see how that looks. Maybe some of my own. The Sparkle White is a nice one. Yeah, for the people that want more information about my own natural mica pigments, it's also in the description box with a link to the Etsy shop of my associate in the USA, because they are also available in the USA and Canada. She also has some great discounts, and she offers a full set of my colors, and I have 48 colors now, so that's great. So if you're curious, then go check out her Etsy shop. For the rest of the world, so the other countries, I have added them also in my Etsy shop. And of course, I also have some nice discounts. So not only for the holiday season we have discounts, but we have through the whole year, we have some nice discounts. Still working on the lines, because I want them nice and straight. Also, the lines need to be on the sides. And I think these markers work very well on top of resin. They are more expensive than other markers, but these, yeah, I like them a lot. Yes, and I also listed these in my Influencers Amazon store. The link to my Influencers Amazon store is also in the description box. And I want to thank the people that already buy through those links, because I earn a little bit of money out of that. But what I always say, all the money goes back into the channel, so to buy the supplies, to make these videos for you all. So I'm almost done with the lines. Then I need to let that dry, and then I will show you all how I add the second layer of resin. So in this part of the video, I'm going to show you how I add a clear coat. I always start in the middle, and then I work my way to the outside of the canvas. First, I'm heating it up to make it more liquid, and also to remove already some air bubbles. And then with my silicone spatula, I work my way to the outside. There you can see it. And of course, I'm using the stone coat art coat, because I also used it in the first layer. So I'm also going to use that as a clear coat, because the stone coat art coat has a high heat resistance, UV protection in it, so that's great. Now I'm adding more to the sides, and I also add this layer because I need to seal those acrylic lines in. If I don't do that, then I can scratch them off, and I don't want that. And I want the bubble areas a little bit under the resin. I don't think it's totally going to cover the bubble effect, but I don't mind, because I also like texture and structure in my art pieces. Heating it again. But I'm very pleased with this experiment. I hope I inspired some people to also try this, because it's a really nice effect. And it's really, yeah, it's easy to do. Again, I'm using my silicone spatula, and now I'm dragging the resin all the way to the side, to the outside. And I'm liking those colors, they are very nice. adding more on the sides, because I also want the sides to be totally covered with the resin. Spreading it with my fingers. The torch for the elbows. More resin onto the bubble effect. Again, the torch. Yeah, I do this several times, the torch, also during drying process, at least the first hour. I go back and check if I have new air bubbles, because then I can remove them still with the torch. Because it's not nice if you have air bubbles in your surface after drying. So I'm done with the clear coat, then I will let this dry, and then after that I can show you all a close-up. So this is the end result. What I already mentioned, it's not totally flat. In the middle I still have some structure, but I don't mind, I like that. But yeah, I really am. I really like the bubble effect. Sorry, I couldn't find a word. So I will for sure use that again. What I already mentioned, it's very nice 3D-like effect, and it's very easy to do. I also like the lines, and that's preference, because some people, will not like it. But I am liking it because the attention is drawn to the middle part that way. There you can see the lines up close. But I'm very pleased with this piece and with my experiment. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe. Click the notification bell and select all what I already mentioned, because that way you don't miss anything. And if you could do it, please give me a thumbs up, because that will help my channel a lot. And I would appreciate it so much if you did that. All the information about the materials I've used are listed in the description box, also at the end of this video. But I also list the websites in the description box, also the link to my Influencers Amazon store. My Facebook, Etsy shop, you name it, all is in the description box. So if you're curious, then go check that out. I want to thank you all for watching again. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.